Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday. I hope you had another great week. I so enjoyed who I got to talk to and talking to you guys this week. I love jumping on the chat with you. And again, I miss you guys so much. I know I say that every time, but it's true. I miss you, and I love you guys so much. But this is the way we can connect and be together until we're all together in some way again. Today is Shakespeare Insult Day, where we take the line of William Shakespeare and we work on our diction and articulation. You know, the four, well, actually the five acting tools. But the four acting tools are using your imagination, your voice, your physical movement and body, your emotions, and the fifth is your self-care, taking care of yourself. So today, we're going to start off with a physical warm-up, just move around. I let you guys just move freely, having a free choice, and then we'll do a little vocal warm-up. And then get into our insult lines for this week, okay? So, and again, guys, when you move around, create a character that you might be, all right? Think of who you might be. Imagine yourself, not in 2020, but imagining yourself in Shakespeare's time. Who might you be? Might you be a king or queen? Might you be a noble person? That's someone who is very, very wealthy. Maybe you were just someone who lived in the town and worked in the town. Maybe you were a baker or a craftsman. You made things out of metal. But who are you? Create a character and just imagine yourself in another time as we move to some music, okay? Guys, when you're moving, make sure you're really trying to engage your whole body, okay? And again, guys, you can also do things from your chair. And listen to the music and let the music kind of inform how you're moving. Right now, it's going a little bit slower. Make sure what you're doing, you're engaging your whole body, guys. Here, we'll just warm up a little bit more. Just get that movement in your whole body. Okay. Humber, you want to move to the music, carry you away. Right, good job, guys. Good, you know, I know you, Alabama, has been making these incredible videos, and his class is giving you a music tour of LA and how the music in LA relating music here in LA and some of how that impacted him and the rich historical musical history we have here in Los Angeles. How I want you to use music and is to let it carry you away. Let it inform your imagination. So when we do a warm-up, you're not only warming up your body, but also letting it carry you to another time period, right? Shakespeare was writing 500 years ago. So let that carry you away. Really imagine if somebody else when we're working on our movement, especially during our Shakespeare Insult Day. Okay, good. Good. So let's warm up our mouths and get ready to do some articulation exercises. We're going to start with the breath. We're going to do the circular breathing where we breathe in, make like a circle with our mouth, breathe in, and blow it out. Again, we're trying to make like a circle with our mouth. Gonna do 10 circular breaths. Ready? Good guys, good, good. And just relax. Good, and let's do a little bit of articulation, all right? So, actually before that, let's do our apple and lemon, that we open wide like we're eating a lemon. Open wide like we're eating an apple, then puckle up like we're sucking a lemon. Ready? And apple and lemon. And the apple and lemon. And apple and lemon. And apple and lemon. An apple and lemon. Good, and let's, we're gonna take our tongue and touch the top of our lip, the bottom of our lip, side to side. So it looks like this. Okay, ready? Top, bottom lip, left side, right side. Top lip, bottom lip, left side, right side. Top lip, bottom lip, left side, right side. Again, top lip, bottom lip, left side, right side. Good. Good. And just chew with chewing a big wad of gum. It's really hard, so you really have to chew that gum. It's like the hardball gum that's really, really hard. So you're just chewing that wad of gum. Good. That was a cell phone alarm. Okay, and actually, I'm going to make sure that's off. We don't have any more. So there we go. Cool. So And let's do a little bit of articulation. We're gonna say bodega, bodega. The B sound, bodega, 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 bodega. I want you to repeat after me, bodega. Bodega, bodega, bodega. Ready? Bodega, bodega, bodega. I'm gonna go to a D, bodega. Dadika, Dadika, F, Fadika, 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 G, Gadika, 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 and G, H, Hadika, we're doing more of the consonants, so Hadika, 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 J. Jadika, Jadika, Jadika. Okay, Kalika, Kalika, Kalika. L, Ladika, Ladika, Ladika. M, Madika, Madika, Madika. N, Nadika. Nadika, Nadika, Padika, 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 and Q, Quadika, 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 Radika, 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 Sadika, 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 Tadika, Tadika, Tadika. We're going to be Vodika, Vodika, Vodika. Vodika, Vodika, Vodika. X and Z have the same type of sound, so we'll just do Zadika, 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 and Y, we forgot Y, Yadika, Yadika, Yadika. Good guys, good. So, and we're all warmed up. Are you ready for some insults? Alright. All right, our first one is from Corey Jimenez at 2, scene 1. Right. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Okay. I'll say that again. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. So again, we're really getting out of those sounds. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. And really get those in sound, guys. Ending sounds. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Okay, try that again. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Try that by yourself now. And I want you to also, you're very annoyed when you say this. So again, as we're starting to add the combination of voice and emotion and breath, you're very annoyed when you say this, alright? Whatever the circumstance, you're really annoyed when you say this. That is the emotion I want you to have, that really annoyed. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Try that. Good. Again. Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. And guys, I've never said this before, we've done these classes, but you can stop the video and work on it, hit pause, rather, work on one, and then come back to it, okay? So it will help you in getting the words. Always feel free to hit pause, work on one, then hit play again, okay? Your abilities are too infant-like for doing much alone. Good! Good job, guys! Let me go on to another one. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. Let him live at Athens at the 14 board. I wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. And this, I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. And I want you to find a hint of sarcasm. Right? I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. And you really find that sarcasm when you say this. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. Really snitty, sarcasm, you know, you do not like this person at all. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. Good, and again, if you need to pause it to work on the line a little bit, to get it into you, that's fine. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. Great, one more time. And remember, get that sarcasm. Great, good job. Do it one more time. I do wish that were a dog, that I might love be something. Good, all right. Alright, so, I must tell you in your friendly ear, so when you can, you are not for all markets. Let's do it neutral right now just to get the words. I must tell you in your friendly ear, so when you can, you are not for all markets. Let's from As You Like It. Scene 5. I must tell you in your friendly ear, so when you can, you're not for all markets. Good. Now, for this one, I want you to be very nervous. You want to say this to this person, but you don't want to hurt their feelings, but you need to be honest. I must tell you in your family ear, so when you can, you are not for all markets. Okay, so that nervous, you're nervous to say this to this person, they ask your opinion, you're telling it, but you're very uncomfortable, very nervous to be this honest with this person. I must tell you in your friendly ear, so when you can, you are not for all markets. Right? Okay, let's try that again. I must tell you in your friendly ear, so when you can, you are not for all markets. Good. B. very nervous, very uncomfortable. You wish you didn't have to say this, but you do. But it makes you very uncomfortable to say these words. Okay? Very nervous, very anxious. I try it again. Good. And again, now I'll repeat it again. I must tell you in your friendly ear. Sell me you can. You are not for all markets. Again, I must tell you in your friendly ear. Sell me you can. You are not for all markets. Good guys. All right, let's do one more. Thou craving God, thou not pitied for, thou wholesome obscene greedy tallow catch. Alright? Thou craving God, thou not pitied for, thou wholesome obscene greedy tallow catch. I want to work on this when we get back to this one. And when we move the list, where there's several things in a row, we need to also make sure we're giving each one an individual weight, okay? We just don't want to list them off. Alright, so first, let's get the words and then get comfortable with the words. Now, clay brain guts. And I'm going to break this down a bit, okay? Thou clay brain guts. Try that first part again. Thou clay brain guts. Thou naughty patted fool. Thou hoarse and obscene greedy tallow catch. Thou clay brain guts. Thou naughty patted fool. A horse and obscene greedy tallow catch. That's from Henry IV, part 1, act 2, scene 2. Okay, so let's again, let's say it just to get the words. A whore brain guts, thou naughty petted fool. A horse and obscene greedy tallow catch. Good. Good. Now, this I want you to say. Yeah, I'm looking at your piece. Your piecing. There's. So you're gonna paint. Yeah, that looks like you're pacing when you say this. Like there's this energy of. You're so angry that at this person that this is what you need to call them, and you're get a piercing energy, and maybe harder for you to pace and look at the words. But you can imagine that you're pacing, all right? Imagine that you're pacing. You can get a little bit of a pacing energy because you're so angry, you're about to explode. You can barely contain yourself. That's what I mean. You know, you're just, you know, so feel that anger, but make sure there's a different way for each one. So that, and that's taking your time, too, though. So, clavering guts. The nothing headed fool. The horse and obscene greedy tallow catch. Build on that, right? Oh. Maybe even there's a breathing right before that, right? You take a breath in there. Oh! The whore brain, the craving guts, the naughty petted fool, the horse and obscene greedy tallow catch. All right? So build on those, right? right? Build on that. Build on each one. Like each one, each of these, they're saying three things. They're saying, yes. So Claiborne guts. Though Daddy Pet is full, though horse and oxen, busy cattle catch. Let that build, God. Let that anger, that rages. It's like building inside, you know, let's, but you're pacing, whatever I need to do, God, is pace, and then stop, say the words, right? So pace, thou horse, thou clamping guts, thou nutty petted fool, thou horse and aunt and greedy tail catch, all right? So pace. That pacing, you're so angry, just pace, back and forth, stop, look that person in the eye, say these words, thou clamping guts, thou nutty headed fool, thou horse and oxen, greedy tattle catch. Good. One more time. Pace. You're so angry. You're so angry. The words, they're in there, but they're not coming out yet. Pace back and forth. Pace. And even if you're sitting, you can pace when you're sitting too. And if you need to sit and pace. You can pace with your body, even if you're not walking, you feel that containment that's about to explode, whether you're sitting or standing, right? So really, feel that anger, pace, let it build, good, stop, good. Good, one more time. Let that anger build, pace. You're building, give each of these a different weight and action. Thou clay-brained guts, thou nutty-petted fool, thou horse and obstinate, greedy tallow cat. Good job, guys. Great job today. Whoops. Good. All right, everyone. Great week of classes today. Great week of classes this week. I will be back next week with more classes. You guys are doing amazing. Keep on working hard. Keep on keeping on, guys. I love you. I miss you. I'll see you all next week. Have a beautiful, beautiful weekend. And, oh wait, before we go, we just did some great work, so shake that out a bit. Alright? So we just did a lot of great emotional work. Let's just shake it out and dance it out a bit before we go. Okay. You know what? I just turned my cell phone up. I forgot. So let's just shake it out without music. Alright? And my cell phone is very slow. It will take forever to go on. Come on. So just shake out that energy. Shake it out. Got something great. Emotional work today. So just shake it out. Let it go. Good. Good. And just nice breath. Blow it out. Take another deep breath in. Blow it out. Another deep breath in. Blow it out. Reach up to the sky. Shake it out. Reach up to the sky. and shake it out. Good, good, good. All right. Saying goodbye, take two. So, guys, anyway, great classes this week. I love you. I miss you. Have a great weekend. Be safe. Take care of yourselves. I'll be back next week with some more classes. Please take care. Bye-bye.